صحيح البخاري 2745 narrated Aisha رضي الله تعالى عنه the wife of the prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم عتبة بن أبي وقاص رضي الله تعالى عنه entrusted his son to his brother سعد بن أبي وقاص رضي الله تعالى عنه saying son of the slave girl of زما is my illegal son take him into your custody so during the year of the conquest of Makkah Saad رضي الله تعالى عنه took the boy and said this is my brother's son who my brother entrusted to me Abu bin Zama got up and said he is my brother and the son of the slave girl of my father and was born on my father's bed then both of them came to Allah's apostle and Saad رضي الله تعالى عنه said O Allah's Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, this is my brother's son, whom my brother entrusted to me. Abu bin Zama radiyallahu ta'ala anha got up and said, this is my brother and the son of the slave girl of my father. Allah's Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, O Abu bin Zama radiyallahu ta'ala anha, this boy is for you as the boy belonged to the bed where He was born and for the adulterer is the stone, i.e. deprivation. Then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to his wife, Awda bint Zama radiallahu ta'ala anha, screen yourself from this boy. When he saw the boy resemblance to Utba radiallahu ta'ala anha since, then the boy did not see Sauda till he died. Sahih al-Bukhari 2746, narrated Anas radiallahu ta'ala anhu. A Jew crushed the head of a girl between two stones. She was asked, Who has done so to you? So and so, till the name of the Jew was mentioned, whereupon the she nodded in agreement. So the Jew was bought and was questioned till he confessed. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam then ordered that his head be crushed with stones. Sahih al-Bukhari 2747 narrated Ibn Abbas radiyallahu ta'ala anhu The custom in old days was that the property of the deceased would be inherited by his offspring as for parents of the deceased they would inherit by the will of the deceased then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala cancelled from that custom whatever he wished and fixed for the Male doubled the amount inherited by the female and for each parent a sixth of the whole legacy and for the wife an eight or fourth and for husband a half of or a fourth. Sahih al-Bukhari 2748 narrated Abu Huraira radiallahu ta'ala anhu. Man asked the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, O Allah's Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, what kind of charity is the best? He replied. Given charity when you are healthy and greedy, hoping to be wealthy and afraid for of becoming poor. Don't delay giving in charity till the time when you are on the death bed when you say give you so much to so and so much to so and at that time the property is not your But it belongs to so and so, your inheritors. Sahih al-Bukhari 2749, narrated Abu Huraira ta'ala anhu. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, "The sign of a hypocrite are three: whenever he speak, he tells a lie; whenever he is interested, he proves dishonest; whenever he promises, he break his promise." Sahih al-Bukhari 2750 narrated Urwa bin Az-Zubair radiyallahu ta'ala anhu Hakim bin Hizam radiyallahu ta'ala anhu said I asked Allah's Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam for something and he gave me and I asked him again and he gave me and said O Hakim radiyallahu ta'ala anhu this wealth is green and sweet is tempting is as fruits and whoever takes it without agreed then he is blessed in it and whoever takes it with greediness he is not blessed it and he is like it one who eats and never gets satisfied, the upper eye giving hand is better than the lower eye tick-tocking hand. Hakim bin Hizam radiallahu ta'ala anhu, and I said, O Allah's Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, by him I sent you with the truth, I will never demand anything from anybody after you till I die, after reward. Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu, I used to call Hakim radiallahu ta'ala anhu to give him something, but he refused to accept anything from him. Then Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu called him to give him something, but he refused. Then Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu said, O Muslims, I offered to him, I Hakim radiallahu ta'ala anhu, his share which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has ordained for him from this booty, and he refused to take it. Thus Hakim radiallahu ta'ala anhu did not ask anybody for anything after the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam till he died. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bestow his mercy upon him. Like and subscribe my channel for more hadith videos. Allah bless you. Allah Hafiz.